The Pirates are smooth sailing as the men's soccer team advances to the third round of the NCAA tournament following their nail-biting 2-1 defeat against Air Force this past Sunday. On the diamond, the softball team continues to struggle as they are 1-1 in their three-game series against UConn, just days after they clinched a walk-off 10th-inning win against Villanova. Looking to the other side of the diamond, the men's baseball team is also flying high as they clinched the Pirates' fifth no-hitter in program history. Finally, as we get to the end of the Pirates' season, what was our favorite shoe sports memories over the last 4 years? So can the men's soccer team take down Virginia Tech in round three? Can the softball team bounce back from their rocky season? And what can we expect from this fired-up baseball team as they take on Creighton? My panel and I will discuss all this and more. I'm Meagan Gonzalez, and this is our Final Hall Talk. Hello and welcome back to Hall Talk. Once again, I'm Meagan Gonzalez, now joined by my lovely panel of seniors. We have Ryan Clayton, Dalton Allison, and Ronny Castaneda. Guys, how are we feeling today?
Let's take two.
I'm feeling great. You know, it's obviously a little sad, the final show, but I'm ready to talk about, you know, some sports we've got going on and then some great memories, too.
Yeah, I feel old, especially after you said it was the senior show. You know, you bring that up. Just as my back is starting to hurt from sitting in this chair, so I'm definitely starting to feel a little old today.
Happy to share this stage with you guys. It's been a fun 4 years. We're going to wrap it all up today. Look forward to it.
Take one.
Now let's get right into it. The Shoe men's soccer team just defeated Air Force last Sunday 2-1, and they're now advancing to the third round of the NCAA tournament. Guys, what did you think of this game? Did you think they'd win? How did you feel about it?
Ready to take three, take three.
Yeah, I personally thought, you know, they would come away with a win here. I was super excited, you know, to see them get the dub. I think this is a great, great team, super hardworking, and it really shows on the pitch.
To be completely honest, I was not surprised by the win. This team has had some really great momentum moving through the season. After they had their COVID pause, they went and they beat Marquette and then Georgetown. So I was expecting a win heading into this Air Force game, and the team absolutely did not disappoint. Some late match dramatics for sure, but what's a good season without dramatics?
Yeah, definitely. I was a little surprised, but in a bad way, let's say. I really thought this team was going to go into this game and just utterly dominate Air Force in that realm. So I was kind of surprised there, but nonetheless, hey, great teams know how to get the win. That's exactly what they did. Also, I want to give a quick shout-out to, likewise, the goalkeeper for the Falcons. 6 saves. He worked his tail off that night, and that's the reason why this game was so close. A couple of lucky plays here and there. It might have saw the Pirates take a bigger lead that we all expected to take, but nonetheless, it was a great game. Pirates got it out.
Now, we have to discuss C.J. Teebling. He really shined during this game, and he tied it up 1-1 in the 89th minute, and then he ended up scoring the winning goal right at the end there. So what did you guys think of his performance? Dalton, let's start with you.
Yeah, you know, I think that's just showing off that Teebling was born with the clutch gene. That's 2 straight games now with the game-winning goal for C.J. Teebling, and that last goal of his was an absolute beaut. I mean, striking it right off the crossbar at point-blank range, that's what you want to see from a leader on your team.
Yeah, definitely. I was so proud to see C.J. Teebling take this, you know, rise this season. I remember he was injured his freshman year, some parts of his sophomore year. So to see him come back and be as dominant as we all knew he could be, that was very important. So I think that was huge. But what really got to me was that amid all the lucky shots and, you know, all the troubled plays the Pirates had, he kept himself composed. There were some points throughout games earlier this season where he would noticeably be frustrated. We didn't saw that this game. He kept himself at the helm and kept it going for his team because he knew his team needed the positive attitude.
Yeah, I have to agree with both of you guys. I mean, you know, you both brought up really good points. Dalton, you talking about the leader that he is, and we really saw that on display in this game, getting the job done late. Same with you, Ronny. Like, I like what you said about his, like, focus. That was the biggest thing for me is how dialed in he looked It sounds a little generic, like, you know, he's hardworking and stuff, but in the end, I think that's absolutely what got them the win, was his play.
Yeah, I completely agree with you all. CJ Teebling really was a standout during this game, and I think he's going to be a standout for the remainder of their season. So now, this is the first time since 2001 that the Pirates have made it this far into the third round of the NCAA tournament, and they now have this matchup against Virginia Tech coming up soon. What are your guys' predictions for this game? What do you think the Pirates have? What do you think their chances are? Ronny, let's start with you.
So I think the Pirates are going to bounce back tremendously from their Air Force game. Now, granted, it's kind of tough to say, you know, bounce back because they won that game. But like I said, it wasn't in the dominant fashion that we're used to. So I think whatever anger, or, you know, whatever, you know, anxiety they have from the last game is going to pour into this one. And they're going to come out like rockets. Coach Lindbergh is an amazing coach. And I think he has something in store for the Hokies.
Yeah, so, you know, I think this is going to be another very close game. These are two very good teams. You know, I think Seton Hall edges this one out, though. I really think they have a super good chance of winning this one. But, like I said, it is going to be a close game. So, I think we're in for another nail-biter.
Yeah, you know, I think the Hokies are a type of chicken, I believe. So, I think that they should be a little scared of the Pirates this evening. They do have a stout defense. Their last matchup against the Oregon State Beavers, they were holding the number one attacking offense in the country to only one goal. They held the top goal scorer in the entire NCAA, Gloire Amanda, scoreless completely. So we know that they have a tough defense, but offensively, they're not too sharp. They have a negative plus-minus margin. So I'm going to give this one to the Hall.
Yeah, see, I agree. I think it's going to be a tough matchup. This is the fourth time in 5 years that Virginia Tech is making it to the Sweet 16, so they obviously have had a good team over the years, so I don't doubt it's going to be a very good game. So what do you guys think this season, because it's been such a great season, as we've talked about, has done for the men's soccer team and for the program as a whole? Ryan, we'll start with you.
Yeah, very quickly, you know, I think this is going to help them big time for recruiting. A win like this, you know, well, getting this far into the season, I think really helps for recruiting. So it'll be interesting to see the future teams here at Seton Hall.
Yeah, you know, I'm not even looking at it in terms of what it's doing for the program. I'm looking at what it does for the greater Seton Hall community. As we all know, basketball wasn't really something to root for this past season. So having a successful team on campus like the men's soccer team really just cheers up the spirits of a school that's dealt with a lot of issues this year.
I'm pretty sure you all know the best form of recruitment. Success. So this season showing that, I think that's tremendous. Coach Lindbergh, if he keeps this going, because you can't just be successful for one season and try to bring in all these recruits. No, this has to be a consistent thing. They got off on the right foot. Now it's going to be up to Coach Lindbergh and the rest of the Pirates to see if they can continue that.
Yeah, like you guys said, I'm excited to see this matchup. I think I'd have to give my win to Virginia Tech, but I think this overall season for the Pirates is really just going to help them move in a positive direction and hope for just great seasons like this in the future. Now, as we move over to the Diamond, this past Sunday, the softball team got a killer win against Villanova with a walk-off win in the 10th inning by a wild pitch, and then Kelsey Carr scored. So what do you think helped the Pirates win and gain this momentum for this game? Ronny, let's start with you.
Two words, Jhené Barricado. First off, the game she had three doubles en route to breaking the Seton Hall record, four doubles. I think that was tremendous. I think she was the reason why these Pirates really, you know, came out and won. Granted, the game did go into extras, so it was kind of, you know, dangerous for them. But nonetheless, I think it's, you know, such an amazing thing. I'd also like to say on a part of Jhené Barricado, she has the record at Seton Hall for the most doubles while missing an entire season. Pretty remarkable from her, so I think that's tremendous. She was definitely the X factor for that game.
Yeah, I would have to put it in drive and go with Kelsey Carr as my player that I was excited about this past weekend. She pitched 4 2/3 innings, very good, and went 3 for 5 at the plate as well. 3 RBIs, Big East Freshman of the Week Kelsey Carr was. She is going to be an exciting player for time to come, and, you know, she's been really good this season as well, so Paige Smith is very lucky to have her on the roster, especially moving forward to what will hopefully be a season of growth next year.
Yeah, the biggest thing for me in that win definitely had to be Ortega, who had 4 hits. I think that was a huge contribution for the Pirates.
Yeah, so playing off that, you guys are all listing off these key players during that game. This happened to be their senior night, where all 6 seniors were honored. So throughout the season, which senior has stood out to you guys the most? Dalton, let's start with you.
Yeah, and for me, it's got to be Janae Barricado. This season, she's been a consistent force. If you look over her career all time, you know, Ronnie mentioned the doubles thing, but a 307 lifetime average with a 510 slugging average as well. That's very impressive, especially at the collegiate level where you're playing in high-level games against some really tough opponents. So, for me, it has to be Barricado.
Yeah, I think Barricado will go down as one of the greatest players in Seton Hall history and this program's history. But the player who I'm going to look at is Darby Pandolfo, a five-year senior, I guess you can put it. But she led the team in batting average, hits, RBIs, and she's the only Pirate to start 28 out of 28 games. Every game for the Pirates she started in. So, listen, she came back next 1 year and came to play. So I think that's very remarkable from her.
Yeah, similar to Dalton. I'm going to go with Barricada as well. You know, her play has been so impressive. Every time she takes the diamond, it's really been fun watching her play these last couple years. So definitely that's the senior that stands out most to me.
Yeah, I was also in between Darby Pandolfo and Janae Barricado. They're both great players, and have just had a tremendous senior season. Playing off of that, we also have Kelsey Carr, who was named the Big East Freshman of the Week recently. So what do you guys think of her? She has three more years here at the Hall. What do you expect from her in her next 3 years? Ryan, let's start with you.
Well, I think she's going to be an absolutely huge success. I mean, it's going to be interesting to see how the rest of the team forms around her. But, I mean, I think if you're looking at the softball team with her, I think there's going to be definitely some success in the future for the Pirates.
Yeah, and I think in terms of we're talking about Carr, I think that this season having those reps is just so beneficial to her, and it's going to grow her as a player. I think within the next two or three seasons, she's going to be first team all Big East.
Yeah, I think first off, the history of this program, we've seen a lot of players really make a stand their freshman year. I mean, we talked about Janae Barricado. She became a starter her freshman year alongside Peyton Beaver, who had an amazing freshman year. Then the year after, Marissa Plaw came in as a freshman and really dominated. So I think she's going to follow suit in that line of freshmen who, really got it going.
Yeah, I completely agree. And coming up real quick, they're in the middle of a series right now. They're 1-1 with their series against UConn. So what do we think for this this third game? Do you think they're going to come out with a win? What do you think? Really quick, speed answer. Ronnie, let's start with you.
I think they can get back. See, what those games do, it's an energy builder. So I think they take that and they go into stores and they get the win there.
I'll be honest, I'm not that confident in the team's ability to get a win. That win against Villanova was really great. I do think that's going to be the highlight of their season, though.
I think they personally get the win, but the bats are going to have to continue to stay hot if they do want to win.
Yeah, I completely agree, and I'm excited to see what that third game has for that matchup. Now, moving over to the other side of the diamond, this past Sunday, the men's baseball team got a no-hitter against Georgetown with senior Tyler Burnham striking out 14 batters and making this the fifth no-hitter in program history, and he was named Big East Pitcher of the Week. So what did you see from Burnham during this game that helped him with that win, that momentum? What did you see from him that really stood out to you? Dalton, let's start with you.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I just saw a lot of tenacity from him. You know, it's not like he had 14 strikeouts in this game. So his control was on and off during it, which is very interesting. So he did have four walks and a balk over the course of the game, but I was really impressed with him, and he showed me a professional mindset by proving that he was able to work through those mistakes that he made and come out with what was a masterful performance.
Yeah, that's probably one of the best games I've ever seen a Pirate play. I think it's so tremendous. And like you said, you talked about tenacity. That's exactly what it is. He stayed with it. I remember he had trouble getting through the first batters in the first sitting, but then he went and he rolled with it. Kept it going, kept the tenacity. I think that was so important. I was so happy to see it live. It's such a great game.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing, talking about the tenacity, his focus in between innings and while he was on the mound was great to see. I think that's one of the biggest reasons, he's been such a great pitcher, senior now, and how he was able to get that great no-hitter. Also, shouts out to you, Ronnie, for doing the Spanish broadcast on WSOU. That was great to hear, man.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, that's super exciting. That was such a fun game to watch, and it's really exciting, not only for the fans that were watching it, but for the program itself. So while we're talking about seniors, Matt Toke played excellent defense at first base, and he also went 7-for-15 in this series against Georgetown. So what did you guys think of his performance at first base, and just how do you think he's doing with the season so far? Ryan, let's start with you.
Yeah, I've personally loved his play this season. I mean, he has been such a force for the Pirates. I've really liked his all-around game, you know, good defender for first base. And, you know, batting has been pretty good as well. So overall, I think, you know, he's been a big key to the success the Pirates have seen this season.
Yeah, 297 batting average, 17 walks. He's a leader in the clubhouse, good in the field. He's giving me shades of Keith Hernandez, to be completely honest with you. You know, you're a leader on the field. You can hit for average, and you're there when your guys need you most. I mean, we saw some of the highlight plays that he was making in that no-hitter. I don't know. I think players like that are crucial to playoff runs when it comes to baseball.
Yeah, Matt Toe came into the season regarded as one of the best, if not the best, defensive first baseman in the entire Big East, and he showed that this season. Not to mention, I mean, during the last out of that game of Tyler Burnham's no-hitter, I was at the edge of my seat because I didn't know exactly what was going to happen, but I'm never doubting Matt Toke ever again. Great play from him. And not to mention, he found his groove offensively, which is just a cherry on top.
Yeah, exactly. That play was a lot to handle as a fan. It was very nerve-wracking, so I completely understand what you mean by that. So the Pirates are currently second in conference play behind Creighton. So what have you thought of their season as a whole? What have you seen from the Pirates that have really stood out and made this such a great season? Dalton, let's start with you.
Yeah, so over the course of the season, the team has been hitting .274. During that span, they've also been holding opponents to a .226 batting average. Those are great numbers. That's exactly what you want to see if you're a baseball team, holding them to that kind of numbers. So as they're firing on all cylinders right now, they're really gaining momentum at the most important time of the season.
Absolutely. And I think what this team has done so far is tremendous. Let's not forget, they had a bit of an up-and-down season early on before they got into conference play. But once they started playing in the Big East, it was all gears all the time. They have to keep that up.
Yeah, I've been really impressed with this season, you know. I honestly didn't think they'd reach second this point. So really been impressed with them. They've really been a nice surprise, you know. Dalton, you talked about earlier with the basketball team being so up and down. I mean, they've been exactly what I need as a Pirates fan, so.
Yeah, and I think as this being our senior year, too, and really seeing the baseball team shine, it's been really great to watch, and I'm really excited to see where the rest of the season takes them. And their next matchup is actually against Xavier for a four-series matchup. So what are we thinking for that series? Do you think the Pirates have a sure win? Do you think they're going to have to work for it? Ronnie, let's start with you.
I mean, every game in the Big East, you're going to have to work for, so. I see, you know, no reason why the Pirates won't walk away with a win. And, you know, they're going to be battling out for first place in the Big East. So I think this Xavier series is the first step in doing so.
Yeah, Seton Hall has won 8 of their last 10. Xavier has lost 4 of their last 6. I see the Pirates, with all their positive momentum, marching into Cincy and really taking out the Musketeers.
I don't know. I personally think this is going to be a split series. So 2 wins and 2 losses for the Pirates.
Yeah, like we've been talking about, I think the Pirates have been really hot lately. They've won 8 out of their last 10 games, and I think it's going to be a sure win, but that'll be an exciting matchup to watch as well. Just like Ronnie said, every matchup in the Big East is going to be one to watch. Now, as we head over to our last segment, this is our senior segment, which is, like Dalton said, so sad, but we have to acknowledge our favorite memories that we've had here at Seton Hall while watching different sports. So, as we welcome Wilnir Louis, he has been directing this whole time, and he's also another senior we want to honor and we want to get his different memories.
Hi, Wilnir.
Welcome, Wilnir. Welcome to the panel. So, guys, my first question. Seton Hall basketball is obviously a very important part of our careers here at Seton Hall. Everybody loves to watch them. Everybody loves to go to Prudential to watch the games. So, in regards to basketball, whether it be calling a game, going to a game, what has been your favorite memory so far? Ryan, let's start with you.
Man, I've seen a lot of great Pirates moments here. If I had to go with one, it would have to be in 2020. I believe they were playing Butler, but the play, of course, is Mamu tipping it in with, like, no time on the clock. That was such a beautiful play. I mean, I was right there for it, you know, working with Pirate TV and stuff. And just to see him, like, tip it in, they really do talk about that, like, you know, athletes or commentators or whatever. Like, it was in slow motion seeing if that ball would go in. So, gosh, like I said, a lot of great memories with basketball games, but that has to be my favorite.
You know, for me, I've been lucky enough to cover the Pirates all 4 years that I've been here, and it's been a blessing. It's been a real ride. But for me, My favorite moment would probably have to be at the Battle of Atlantis. No, not Battle. Yeah, Battle of Atlantis. Yeah. That's what it was called. Down in the Bahamas, I went with Jose, and they were playing Iowa. And as Tyrese Halliburton, who's now on the Sacramento Kings, was going up for a lay-in, the lights went off. And I knew that it went in, and Jose knew that it went in, but we couldn't tell anyone because the power had went out in the entire facility, and we weren't able to talk. So that, to me, that's a moment that sticks out to me personally.
You know, I'm never going to forget my first ever road trip covering the men's basketball team alongside this man over here to my left. And by way of Dalton Allison, who was a sports director at the time over at SOU. So that was one of the, you know, funnest experiences I had. That was the Miles Powell return game after his concussion. It came back, led the Pirates to a win against DePaul, showed me Chicago, which is, you know, now probably the most beautiful city I've ever stepped foot in. So that was one of my favorite memories, most definitely.
I mean, it definitely is going to be tough for me in terms of what my favorite memory is in terms of Seton Hall basketball. You know, RC, I definitely agree with you. That game, me and Liam played, who's right now manning camera two, we were on the call for WSU, and just our call on that was absolutely electric. And, you know, Liam played, you know, he I know he wants to smile right now, but his call on that one made that call fantastic. But to be a little bit different, too, the St. John's game at home as well. I wasn't on the call, but Dalton Allison was on that call. And that was when Bob Lee actually made his return on WSU as well. So, now those two games were definitely one of my favorite games to attend.
Yeah, these are all such great memories, guys. Thank you so much for sharing those. I would say my favorite basketball memory is actually the last home game. Correct me if I'm wrong. That was against UConn, right?
Yes, yeah, it was.
Yeah, so me and my best friend, Ash Stepper, got to go to the game, and we got to go for Pirate TV, and we got to report live and do the Instagram live and different things like that and report the post-game report. And with that, it was so great because this being such a different season, like not being able to go in person, just getting that one last game to be like, hey, you know what, that last season, my senior year, I did get to go to one game. And it was great, and I think it really, even though the Pirates lost that game, I think it was really great just for them to have fans there for their senior night and just enjoy that last home moment they had. Now as we're talking about our senior moments in sports, aside from basketball, what would you guys say has been your favorite Seton Hall sports memory aside from basketball? So that could have been, once again, calling something, going to a different sports game. Ryan, let's start with you.
Oh, man. So for my favorite non-basketball sports memory, I'm taking it all the way back. I'm going to go with my first assignment I ever did with Pirate TV. It was a women's soccer game back in the fall. You know, that was my first time on camera, first time doing something with Pirate TV like that. It was me and the lovely Liam Plate getting to do that and stuff. And, you know, I really think about that moment and just, like, all the crazy things that followed it. You know, I consider myself really lucky to have had the experience I've had here at Seton Hall, and that was a fantastic start to it, so definitely that.
Yeah, by way of Seton Hall, I've been lucky enough to see some really cool stadiums, some really cool sporting venues, two of which I went to with two of the people who are here next to me. So I went to AT&T Stadium in Dallas, Texas with Ronny. That was so much fun, and I was in shock the entire time being a big Dallas Cowboys fan. And then I went to Safeco Field with Wilnir all the way out in Seattle. And let me tell you something, that was a trip that you had to be on.
I mean, it's hard for me to pick. I mean, Ryan, you talked about me calling a no-hitter in Spanish. I mean, that was tremendous. But, you know, I'll never forget the amount of times I lost my voice at a Seton Hall sporting event, ripped my pants a couple times, too, out of just sheer excitement. So, I mean, listen, there are too many moments for me to pick from. But, I mean, this was definitely, you know, a fun ride. I never would have expected my years at Seton Hall to be influenced by, you know, so many great people and by so many opportunities. So I can't really pick one. It's just overall excitement these past 4 years.
Hey, see, I want to go the easy way out and not pick one either, but instead I'll go two different ones. The first one, a volleyball game, which Liam Plate, your third shout out of this show. Me and Liam Plate were on that broadcast, and the second set of that matchup went, I think, up to like 46-44 was the final score on that one. So, you know, just being able to broadcast that and the high energy on that game was electric. And to go to another broadcast a little bit more recently for WSOU, Veronica Gale, who's switching right now when Meagan Gonzalez, our host, went on WSOU's online streams for the first time for a softball game. And both of them were fantastic, and I was happy just to be able to be on that broadcast and just hear them, who hasn't broadcast ever a live game, you know, to be able to hear them and to see all that, and that was absolutely exceptional.
You took the words right out of my mouth. That's the one I was going to use. So that game was so great because, like Wilnir said, I've always done Pirate TV. I've never really done WSU before. So the fact that he gave me a chance to get to go to that softball game with my fellow woman in sports, Veronica Gale, it was so much fun just to be able to spread my softball knowledge and just, you know, as I joke with Wilnir, come out of retirement one last time just to talk about it. But that was such a great time. So thank you for letting me go to that. And that really will be a memory that I will never forget. And I'm sure, as you guys stated, all those memories, ones that you will never forget. So that will end our senior segment and this episode of Hall Talk. Thank you all so much for this amazing 4 years. As I sign off for my senior panelists, we have Ryan Clayton, Dalton Allison, Ronny Castaneda, and Wilnir Louis. I'm Meagan Gonzalez. Thank you so much, and this was our final Hall Talk.